This is an autonomous Ekranoplan, or ground effect vehicle using custom Arduplan code written by a genius named Sebastian that utilizes a light detection and ranging, or LIDAR, unit on the bottom of the wing to automatically hold a preset altitude. This is enabling Daniel from RC Test Flight to steer this 16-pound monster around the lake like a boat, simply pushing it left or right to go wherever he wants. Oh, and there's me in that thing. So how did this project come about? Buckle up and hold on to your shorts, the story is a little convoluted. Basically, Daniel did this autonomous boat, which inspired me to reach out and see if he wanted to try this autonomous Ekranoplan. Check out his video on that. And when the flying ship company spoke with Daniel about a possible demonstration vehicle, he reached out. Come on, man. Man. Oh, okay, there you go. We created this thing. Daniel agreed to get the electronic side of things going by testing the system out on the Ekranoplan I had created for that collaboration. I was responsible for the build side of things. The flying ship company gave me a lot of design freedom to create something that would fly well at this scale, yet would still communicate the idea effectively of what they are up to. If you are unfamiliar with the concept of ground effect, let me offer a few explanations. The simple version is that the phenomenon known as ground effect begins to occur approximately one half the wingspan of the aircraft in question from the ground and becomes more powerful the lower it goes. Lift is increased due to a ram effect and the drag is decreased due to weaker wingtip vortex formation. The less simple answer is that not only is lift increased as you would expect due to the ram effect, but also due to an increase in the perceived angle of attack on the wing. And though the angle of attack is effectively increased in ground effect, the induced drag is not, as the lift distribution is also more elliptical, which explains the weakening of the vortex. Wrapping your head around that concept may not be fun, but flying a vehicle in ground effect sure is.
Ooh, you should fly one more time.
So for this project, I needed some serious manufacturing help, and that's where my buddy Andrew comes in, who designed and fabricated these custom wing joiners, and he made them out of a solid block of aluminum. He made the mold out of a solid block of aluminum, and this thing is a work of beauty. So he also created some other things for me. The taper on the wing is massive. And we needed a custom feather cut hot wire cutter just for this set of wings. And he also did a couple other things for this project, and it would not have happened without him. So Andrew, you are the man. For those of you who did not watch my last Ekranoplan video, here is a quick recap of a major design consideration. A peculiar phenomenon occurs where, as an Ekranoplan rises out of ground effect, the center of pressure of the vehicle moves forward, and the aircraft wants to flip over on its back. And as the vehicle descends into ground effect, the center of pressure moves back and the aircraft wants to dive into the surface. A commonality you may have observed among ground effect vehicles that are able to transition to and from ground effect is an enormous horizontal stabilizer that is not in ground effect. This feature allows for that center of pressure to shift without losing control of the vehicle and creates a much safer vehicle. Once I had all the parts on hand, the build could commence. Before starting, it was important to waterproof the servos and connectors using Corrosion X HD, as this would be seeing ocean duty. After that, it was a pretty simple build. As you can see, I knocked it out in 30 seconds or so. Okay, so I am very happy with this float test. You can kind of see we're sitting a little deep in the water, but remember we're 2 pounds overweight. So, and when it starts planing, that will instantly leave the back end. We're sitting at a good angle in the water. The nose is a little bit high, but when I cut out the chines, that'll drop the nose down just a little bit more. So I think it's just a matter of refining it and making it look good at this point. After getting the Ekranoplan going, it took a week to solve some speed controller problems, but hey, not your problem, and so it was on to the maiden flight. I won't lie, I was pretty nervous for this maiden flight. But once it became apparent that everything was working as planned, the courage gradually came back and I began to bring the plane lower and lower to see if this thing could do what it was made for. Not my finest landing.
How do you feel now?
Like, not a million. Day two required even more courage, as I needed to switch out of stabilized modes to see if we had the center of gravity as far back as it could safely go. This vehicle is somewhat of a paradox, as I would not describe flying without stabilization as fun, yet when stabilized is one of the most serene flying experiences I have ever had. By the end of day two, I had pretty much mastered keeping this thing in ground effect at will, even at the limits of vision. It was time to set it aside until Daniel dropped in and took it to the next level. And I assure you, there was a next level.
So that's just changing the throttle proportionally to the distance sensor reading.
Pretty cool. Sick. Daniel took about 3 hours to do what would have taken me 2 days to do, which was to set up the plane with a new autopilot using Sebastian's custom code. All it took was one flight for him to get used to the vehicle, and we then commenced ground effect testing and filming.
That is buttery. Oh, that's so good.
I don't have much to say about what unfolded over the next 2 days of testing, other than enjoy.
wires. Faces without names, playing devils and angels, lit up by the strobes, moving hypnotized. I caught your reflection in the neon on glass, an electric silhouette against a static sky. It's a beautiful dream, it's a beautiful life, it's just a reflection, a world that must survive. We're children of the past, we look beyond today, designing the present. So when is the future? We live in a dream, keeping visions alive. It's just a reflection, a world that never dies. The image we create, in our image we design. It's a beautiful life, so when is the future? Time moves so fast, in a single direction, fighting with the present, racing from the past. We're searching for something that can never satisfy the reality of answers when lives are on the line. I've waited a lifetime for the age of wonder, a place that I remember in a splinter of time. A stranger in a strange land, caught in the flow, still searching for answers among the neon lights. It's a beautiful dream, it's a beautiful life, it's just a reflection, a world that must survive. We're children of the past, we look beyond today, designing the present, so when is the future?
Kevin, come check this out. This is the LiDAR data from one of the ground effect passes. So here you can see the flight path did a big loop out like that. And this is what the rangefinder data looks like. So it kind of looks like it's oscillating a little bit, maybe, but I mean, I didn't really notice just by looking at the aircraft, so.
But it's not oscillating anymore like when you're doing the turn. It's staying
the
same oscillation in the turn as when you're doing straight.
Yeah, it seems pretty good. I'm really, really happy with this data because when I'm flying, like in Seattle, on rougher water usually, the data is all over the place, and you get the rangefinder reading zero sometimes. Like, that's basically just false data. And here, we're not reading anything but, like, accurate data.
So, how much variation is that?
So this is meters.
Okay.
So it's going between, like, 0.4 and 0.7 meters peak to peak, so.
That's pretty tight.
Yeah. Seems like it's holding altitude really well, I'd say.
Excuse me, sir. Is that a drone?
No.
It's a spaceship. Manta ray. It's an ocean spaceship.
It's a squirrel. Flying squirrel.
Kind of looks like one. Cabin's nervous. It's a kite. High seas.
There is a pretty good chance that this demonstration vehicle will see less than ideal conditions.
Oh yeah, those are some big waves.
So Daniel and I went hunting for some wind and waves. We got what we asked for, and the Ekranoplan handled it like a champ.
We're recording.
With Daniel's excellent piloting.
Good job, Daniel.
If you got to the end of this video and feel like other people ought to see it, do the normal YouTube-y stuff to let the algorithm know you appreciated it. Best of luck to the Flying Ship Company with their new demonstration vehicle. The future is nearly here.
Oh, so sweet. Damn, amazing.